One more example with radio buttons. You see that this dialog has two radio buttons, so you can either pick this option or that option. And unlike with the command link buttons, the action is not executed right away. You make a selection and then you click OK or cancel or the buttons that you define. And you, in addition to that, you also have the option to specify a verification text so that this question is not posed another time, or whatever the verification text says. So I'll teach you how to specify these radio buttons, how to specify the OK button, get the result if the OK button was clicked, or a cancel button was clicked. I'm going to extend the example a little bit, and I'm also going to explain how you can query the result of the verification text if it is checked or not checked. Sometimes I drive people nuts because I always start at the beginning again and again and again. But if you followed all the examples, you already know what I'm going to start with. I'm going to start with a title, and this is the task dialog with radio button and verification text. We are not going to touch the footer because the verification text, even though it appears in the footer, is not part of the footer properties. The instruction text, however, is saving application settings, and the content, this is the content. And now how to specify the radio buttons. The radio buttons you find in the property radio buttons, which is a string list. So you simply list what the radio buttons are supposed to say. So store settings in registry and store settings in XML file. If you want one more, you simply keep on adding lines in the string list editor. But we're gonna stay with those two as in the example. And if we preview the dialog now, oh my God, this is almost what we want. The only thing missing is the verification text. And there's the property verification text. Do not ask for this setting next time. So we should almost be there. Let's specify a cancel button in addition to the OK button. So our common buttons are CB OK, CB cancel, and voila, there we go. Also, by default, we want that the do not ask for this setting next time is set. So for that, we have an option, which is called do verify checked. If you check this setting, the dialog by default checks the verification text. Just like the other example where the user could select something, you need to be able to react to those selections. Again, I'm going to place a button on the form, and if task dialog execute, and again, I only want to have a look at the results if it is the OK button that the user clicked. So system.uitypes.idOK. Again, we have to use the unit system.uitypes. Of course, you can also learn the constants. You know, you don't need to use placeholders, but I always think it makes more sense using these constants because it keeps the source code very much readable. Then begin. And if the user clicks OK, what is supposed to happen? Well, we want to evaluate the result of which radio button was clicked. So if the first radio button was clicked, we set the settings to be stored in the registry. And if the second button was selected, it means that we want to store the settings in an XML file. There is a property called, and I'm going to store this property in lResult. The property is of type integer, lResult equals task dialog radio button result, which is an integer. The only thing we have to think about now is what is the number that lResult is filled with if the user selects the first or the second one. So what we do is, in order to learn these things, we display it with a show message in order to see what happens. First of all, if we click cancel, nothing's displayed. If we click store settings in registry, which is the first entry, it's 200. And the second entry is 201. And this is very similar to the custom buttons that you can define. Those start at 100 and the radio button start at 200. So what you can do is, if lresult equals 200, then begin show message store in registry. And if lresult equals 201, then advanced show message store in XML. Let's see if this works. In registry, cancel. Nope. In registry, okay. Perfect. Store in registry. Store settings in XML file. Store in XML. And now the final part, the verification text. Just like for the radio button result, there's a task dialog verify result, which gives you a Boolean, either true when it's checked and false if it's not checked. Of course, we can't do anything that makes sense in this video, so I'm going to keep it at that. In summary, you have seen simple and very complex task dialogs, and TMS makes it a bliss to work with these components, as all the properties are not only available at runtime, but also during design time. The preview at design time is very useful in the beginning when you start working with this component. And at some point, you're not going to rely on the design time anymore. You're going to build these components, or you're going to fill up your task dialogs at runtime with source code. You're not going to rely on the design time as much anymore. Hopefully these video tutorials helped you, that you'll in the future select task dialogs instead of all the previous standard dialogs that you've used.